Every 11 seconds somewhere in the world, a ransomware attack strikes. Imagine this. You open your laptop one morning and instead of your desktop, you are greeted by a chilling message: your data has been encrypted. And the attackers demand millions to get it back. As an organization or individual, what would you do? Would you pay the ransom or risk losing everything? This isn't just a hypothetical situation. It's the reality that businesses and individuals are facing in 2025. Ransomware has become the shadowy kingpin of cybercrime, and it's not going away anytime soon. In today's video, we are diving deep into how ransomware is taking over and, more importantly, what's next. In 2023 alone, ransomware victims paid a staggering $1.54 million on average. That's double the previous year. And here's the kicker. 83% of the organizations hit by ransomware caved in and paid their attackers. But why? Because the alternative of shutting down operations and losing critical data was even worse. But how did we get up here and what does this mean for the future? Let's discuss. Let's pull the curtain on ransomware. At its core, ransomware is a simple concept. It is a type of malicious software, often referred as malware, used by cyber criminals to lock or encrypt your files and systems, making them inaccessible. The attackers then demand ransom payment, often in cryptocurrency, in exchange for a decryption key to regain access to your data. Essentially, it's like someone breaking into your house, locking your valuables in a box, and only giving you the key after you pay them. But what's changed is how ransomware operates. You must have heard of three main cloud service models: infra, platform, and software as a service. But welcome to the era of ransomware as a service. Yes, it is a thing. Think of it like a subscription service for hackers. You don't know how to code? No problem at all. You can rent ransomware kits, complete with user-friendly dashboards and customer support. For a cut of the ransom, these services will help you target victims. Simply cybercrime made convenient. So apparently, even criminals hate writing code. This gig economy of cybercrime is what makes ransomware so dangerous. It's no longer just elite hackers orchestrating these attacks. Anyone with a grudge and a few dollars can become a cybercriminal. Take the Colonial Pipeline attack in 2021. A ransomware group called DarkSide shut down the largest fuel pipeline in the US, causing widespread panic and fuel shortages. The group reportedly earned over $4.4 million in ransom before being partially dismantled. But ransomware doesn't stop at encryption. It has evolved and meet its more sinister sibling, extortionware. In a ransomware attack, your data is encrypted. But in an extortionware attack, hackers take it a step further. They steal your data and threaten to leak it until you pay up. It's not just about losing access anymore, it's about losing control. Imagine being a business owner and receiving this email. What do you do? Would you risk your reputation or face lawsuits? Extortionware leaves you with no good options and it's becoming alarmingly common. In 2023, a ransomware group called Lockbit targeted a major healthcare provider. Instead of just encrypting patient data, they threatened to release private medical records unless a ransom was paid. This attack didn't just cost money, it shattered trust. So yeah, next time you are annoyed at a two-factor authentication prompt, maybe thank it for keeping your bank account out of hackers' hands. But here's where things get even more terrifying. With advancement in AI, ransomware attacks are becoming faster, smarter, and harder to detect. In some cases, ransomware can encrypt entire system in under a minute. That's less time than it takes to make a cup of coffee. Now the question is how we can fight back, and what's the solution? It starts with awareness. Cybercriminals thrive on ignorance and complacency. Here are a few steps you can take to protect yourself and your business. First is, always back up your data, preferably offline. Backing up your data ensures that you have copies of important files. Even if a ransomware attack occurs, offline backups are crucial because they cannot be accessed or encrypted by attackers targeting your network. Second is, use multi-factor authentication. Even if attackers obtained your credentials, they won't be able to log in without the second authentication factor. I know I have stressed a lot on this point in my videos, but trust me, this is very crucial. Third is, Train employees to spot phishing attempts. Employees should be trained to identify suspicious emails, links, or attachments, as these are often the entry points for cyber attacks. Fourth is encrypt sensitive data. Even if the attacker gains access to your files, encrypted data would be useless without the decryption keys. This step minimizes the impact of breach or data theft. Fifth is use EDR tools to monitor for unusual activities. EDR solutions like CrowdStrike Falcon, SentinelOne, and Microsoft Defender can actively monitor and identify threats before they cause significant damage. But EDR tools are just one part of the puzzle. Let's talk about our final and most important point is system patching, an often overlooked but critical defense mechanism. Many ransomware attacks exploit known vulnerabilities in outdated software. Regular patching can close these security gaps, making it harder for hackers to get a foothold. And most importantly, stay informed. Cybercrime is constantly evolving, but so are our defenses. The key is to stay one step ahead. If you want to stay updated on latest cybersecurity trends and how to protect yourself, don't forget to subscribe our channel and check out my playlist on cyber updates. It's packed with actionable tips and deep dives into ever-changing world of cybercrime. Don't let ransomware or extortionware catch you off guard. Hit that playlist and take control of your digital security. See you in the next video. Until then, stay safe, stay secure, and take care.